Now we move on to the third kind of cytoskeleton. It is called microtubule. So yes, now let's talk about the microtubule. So what are microtubules? Microtubules are a third kind of cytoskeleton. They are made up with tubulin protein. They are made up with tubulin proteins. So these tubulin proteins are, here is the structure of a tubulin protein. As you can see, it is made up with the two dimer. It is made up with one dimer, so two monomer, that means one dimer. It is one beta tubulin, another one is alpha tubulin. So we can see the beta tubulin and alpha tubulin attach with each other. They have a binding site for ATP. But memorize one thing, that this beta tubulin is the most important monomer among this alpha and beta tubulin, because this beta tubulin can attach with ATP or ADP. So if beta tubulin is attached with ATP, that means if it is attached with ATP, that means it is active. And if it is attached with ADP, so I have some problem with my mouse, so it is very, very difficult to write down with mouse. Anyways, so if it is attached with ADP, that means it is inactive in nature. So what happens, this tubulin dimer will come in and attach with ATP. So ATP beta tubulin dimer is active, so this dimer will come in and attach with each other to finally arrange themselves in such a way. So one by one they arrange in a linear structure like that. Now one by one linear structure will come together, and if we make a sheet like this, then we fold this sheet up to finally give a three-dimensional array like structure like this. So we can finally end up with making a tubulin. So it's a tube. So tubulin is a kind of tube made up with tubulin dimer proteins, and this tube is made throughout the throughout a sheet made up with this alpha and beta tubulin. The sheet is made by aligning one by one a strand of these tubulin proteins. Okay, so this is how the tubulin is arranged. We're going to see how this arrangement is done in the future slide with the animation. It will clear your concept very much. Now let us talk about the arrangement and how this arrangement is done. So if we have this dimer of alpha and beta tubulin, and this beta tubulin is attached with GTP. So I have talked about ATP previously, but this is not a ATP. It is very much important for GTP, because it is GTP bound protein. So if GTP bind to it, then it is active. If GDP bind to it, then it is inactive. So if GTP bind to the beta tubulin, it is active in nature. Now this active dimer come in, and this active dimer attached with another dimer, then it is attached with another dimer to make a polymer of tubulin. It is called the tubulin protein, and the polymer of tubulin will be called a microtubule when the tubulin is arranged in a cylindrical arrangement. Okay, now here is the tubulin arrangement. Now after some time, when the GTP is hydrolyzed, GDP is made, and this tubulin will getting very much unstable, and it will be dissociated. Now why they are becoming unstable? Because of when the GTP bind to this tubulin proteins, then the tubulin is having a particular straight angle in their structural configuration, straight angle. But whenever GDP replaces the GTP, it's slightly tilted in some way. So it is slightly changed in its angle through its axis. That makes, you can see in this picture, it will bend their structure, linear structure, in a few degree, and this bending helps to dissociate. So if we are looking at there, this is a growing phase of tubulin protein polymer, and this is a shrinking phase. In the growing phase, it is growing straight, but in the shrinking phase, what is happening when the GTP is hydrolyzed to GDP, then this microtubule B, tubulin B along with GDP is unstable, and they will enter into the state like this carved state. So they will dissociate like a peeling of banana like structure like that. So it can be easily seen in electron micrograph. I do not catch the picture of this electron micrograph, but still you can see in this dramatic representation that they can peel off like that. Okay, now what is this at the assembly point? So if we think about the polymerization purposes, again in this case too, we can see the polymerization of lag phase, where we have no simple tubulin proteins, but no assembly of tubulin to make microtubule. Then we suddenly increases the growth rate and finally make them much more microtubules with those tubulin proteins. And after some time, it reaches a constant, it reaches an equilibrium. In this equilibrium, no longer tubulin proteins will associate to make microtubule. It is stabilized at that state. Okay, it will reach the equilibrium phase. Okay, and what is going on in this case is either assembly or disassembly, and the assembly side is called again positive and disassembly side is called the negative. In the assembly side we have the GTP, bind state of the tubulin, and then negative side we have GDP, bound state of the tubulin. Okay, and in all this case alpha tubulin plays a role of making the structure stable, but beta tubulin is making a structure of assembly and disassembly, or regulation of assembly and disassembly. That's why the beta tubulin is much more important. And these tubulin proteins are typical proteins which is helping the cell to divide. When a cell start to divide, it needs to produce the array of microtubules. So this array of microtubules are called spindles, as you know, it called spindles. The spindles will help to dissociate, to segregate the sister chromatids during the cell division. And the sister chromatid segregation is really important, because after the sister chromatid segregation, the new cell will be made, and in those new cell nucleuses, those one copy of the sister chromatid will go and to make a final copy of nucleus. That's why the sister chromatid division is really important. If anything wrong happens during the sister chromatic segregation, then it will end up with the abnormality in the chromosomal number. Okay, so that's why it's really important. Now let us look at the animation of microtubule assembly and disassembly. It is an animation narrated by Ivan Nogolas, and let's see.
Microtubules are dynamic cytoskeletal polymers essential for all cells. They are made of the protein tubulin, an alpha-beta heterodimer that self-assembles head-to-head, making protofilaments, which themselves associate laterally, making a cylindrical wall. Tubulin binds the small molecule DTP, or guanosine triphosphate. During microtubule polymerization, this molecule is hydrolyzed to GDP, or guanosine diphosphate. The GDP-bound form of tubulin is unstable in the microtubule and give rise to the phenomenon of microtubule dynamic instability, by which microtubules switch between growing and shrinking phases. When microtubules lose a critical layer of GTP-containing tubulin subunits, shown in brown, they depolymerize by peeling and curving of the protofilaments. Although protofilament peels are short-lived, we stabilize them for structural analysis to define the tubulin arrangement and conformation within them. These disassembly intermediates break down into smaller pieces. We found that in the GDP depolymerized form, the tubulin dimer makes bent contacts but is also bent itself with a 12-degree angle. Upon GDP exchange for GTP, the tubulin subunit is straightened, allowing it now to repolymerize, making both longitudinal and lateral interactions. The resulting assembly intermediate is an open sheet that is very short-lived, but we were able to stabilize into helical ribbons that were amenable to structural studies by electron microscopy and image analysis. This polymer shows the protofilaments arranged in pairs, with contacts that alternate between those found in the cylindrical microtubule and new contacts never described before. The arrangement is set to be able to roll into a tube when it reaches the right width and length. The closing up of the microtubule is a highly cooperative zipping up process. Thus, microtubule growth occurs by sequential sheet extension followed by microtubule closure. Driven by the hydrolysis of GTP, microtubules switch between growing and shrinking phases via the structural intermediates just described, giving rise to a very dynamic cellular cytoskeleton that performs essential functions in the cell, from transport of cellular organelles to division of the genetic material between daughter cells during cell division. Microtubules are fascinating nanodevices that have evolved to undergo amazingly complex assembly processes.
Really nice animation. I hope every queries about microtubules is getting cleared after seeing this animation. And now we're going to discuss about the control of making this microtubule and the tubulin. So again, we are talking about a polymer microtubule, which is a polymer of this tubulin protein. So tubulin dimers are there, and we are talking about a balance between making this tubulin and microtubule together at a particular time. And there again, different effector proteins are there, which is helping to make to assemble and disassemble this this tubulin proteins to make microtubule. And some of these proteins are gamma turc, is called is a typical protein which helps to nucleus and assembly of this tubulin proteins to make microtubule. Okay, so this gamma turc will most of the time seen in case of centromere. Centromere, remember, is a place through which is also called the microtubule organizing center, or MTOC. And through the centromere portion, this centromere uses this lots of this tubulin and arrange those tubulins together to make huge number of microtubules, because they need microtubule at the situation. Actually, these centromeres are the place which give rise to the formation of the spindles, which are being necessary for the cells to segregate the non-sister segregate the chromatids during the cell division. Okay. Now let's talk about statmin. Statmin is a kind of protein which binds to the subunit and prevents assembly. Statmin binds to the subunit of this tubulin, probably the alpha subunit of the tubulin, and it will block the assembly of tubulin to make a microtubule. Okay. Now let's talk about TIPs. It remain associated with the growing plus end, and can link then either to the structures such as membranes, because sometimes the microtubule has to be attached with membranes because of the microtubule growth is needed in some cases, because the astral spindles which are being generated during the cell division from a centromere will be sometimes interact with the cell membrane. In those situations, these kind of proteins like TIPs will help them to attach and link with the cell membrane or different structures resemble to cell membrane. Okay. Now let's talk about some proteins which will interact with fully grown microtubule and how they modify their structure. So a simple protein is MAP, which stabilizes the tubule by binding to the sites. So MAP, what MAP does, MAP come and bind with this alpha and beta subunit of microtubulin proteins, and it stabilizes this microtubule structure. And we also have catenin protein, which severs microtubule. So this catenin protein is there to sever the microtubule. And we also have this XMAP215 is a designation of a protein which stabilizes the plus end of the molecule and accelerates the assembly. So the accelerate assembly is done by here the gamma turc as well as XMAP. And MAP helps to stabilize the microtubule, but do not helps to grow the placenta in very far. And now let's talk about the final kind of protein, which is called here is kinesin. Kinesin is a motor protein. So this motor protein enhances the catastrophic disassembly of the placenta. So it helps to disassembly of this molecule. So it helps in disassembly. This helps in assembly. Gamma turc helps in assembly, and XMAP also helps in assembly, and MAP helps in stabilization. So these are the actual work of different proteins along with microtubules. Some will interact with the tubulin dimer, some will interact with the fully grown microtubule, but the basic idea is to keep the equilibrium between the tubulin protein and microtubule in a particular constant manner. Okay. Now, as we have talked about the kinesin, now let's talk about kinesin in much more detail. So, what are these motor proteins? As we know, these motor proteins are really important during the cell division, because these motor proteins are actually generating the force of either assembly or disassembly during the cell division, where these microtubules are need to sometimes getting improved, sometimes getting dissociate or shrink. So sometimes this microtubule has to be getting increase in length, sometimes they have to be getting increased decreased in length, which is called the shrinking. So this growing and shrinking, which we call the rapid disassembled nature, or we called rapid dissociation nature of this microtubule, which is a characteristic of microtubule, which is helping the microtubule to grab and hold on to the nuclear hold on to those chromatids and segregate them, will need the help of this kinesin molecules.